Well, welcome to Mount Van Hovenberg, and it's a picture postcard day, and you can see Whiteface Mountain in the distance there, where the alpine skiing is taking place. But we're here for the second day of cross country, and this is the sprint events, the women's and the men's sprint competitions. So the way this competition works, it's fast, it's exciting. It's on the sprint track, 1.5 kilometers long. We'll have two semi-finals. The top two will automatically go through, and then there are two fastest losers, or two lucky losers, that will go through to make up the final. So air temperature, -6. It's warming up though in the sun, and the radiation of the sun is heating things up quite nicely here. And it's time now for the first semi-final of the women's competition. And they're off. Well, good start there from Antosova. Barbara Antosova of the Czech Republic leading out of the first hill, with the Finn, Tiina Oikkanen, in second. Erin Bianco keeping her powder dry there, just making sure she stays in the slipstream, doesn't use up too much energy early on. You're gonna need it for the climb, the big climb. A little bit of cat and mouse going on here. No one really wants to take up the lead. So we're coming up to the dead turn, and it is Tiina Oikkanen that will lead around the turn. Barbara Antosova of the Czech Republic. Bianco going hard up the hill. Watch out for the American now. It's Bianco leading, Oikkanen in second, Antosova and Czech in third. Oh, but they're really tight, really bunched together. This is going to be neck and neck as they come down this descent. Who's got the quickest skis? Who can ski out this right-hand bend? Using the slipstream. There's moves going on. Erin Bianco safely out in front. That's where you want to be going into this final turn. You want to stay out of trouble. We've seen so many coming together. Bianco is in the lead. And it is Bianco followed by Oikkanen. There's a move from number five, Pules. Pules, can she do it? I think Pules is going to do it. And it is Bianco, Pules and Oikkanen that will go through to the final. That will be down to time, so Tiina Oikkanen will need to wait and see. 258.82. Who's going to be the lucky losers? So time for the second of the women's semi-finals. So here we go. And who's going to lead us out? It's going to be Swifei, I think.
Dropping right out in front, right out of the starting blocks.
Followed by Veronika Kaleta of Poland. So we've got France, Poland, Niemelä of Finland. Sweet Fay leading, moved here by Veronica Kaleta, wearing bib number two, the red and white of Poland. And just watch for Anna Maria Dietz of Germany. She's sitting right back in the last place right now. Gonna have to move up the field now, though. Well, this is where the rubber hits the road as they come around this dead turn. And it's all or nothing up the hill, and Dietz is moving forwards. Conserved energy. Now it's time to expend all of your energy, as much as you possibly can. Blast up this hill. And Anna Maria Dietz has moved up from last place and now is powering up on skier's left. Niemelä of Finland, Kaleta of Poland, Suifre of France, Dietz moving up. Going to be those four. One of those four is going to lead on the descent. Colombo of Italy just a little bit distance in fifth as they go over and onto the descent. Now, the glide. Niemelä of Finland leading us in. Anna Maria Dietz of Germany in second place as they come around the final corner. And they're on to the start, finish straight. And it's flat out towards the line. It's going to be Niemelä of Finland that's going to take this. And Dietz of Germany, is she going to get second? It is. Good ski there from the German. Niemelä, well, her tactic was to try and lead that one out from the start. But the German, Anna Maria Dietz, sitting at the back, waiting to make a move on the hill. And she did just that. And having a look at the time, Veronica Kaleta, I think, might miss out. Amélie Suifre and Kaleta are not going to go through as the quickest. So those qualifications will come through from the first of the semi-finals. But before we move on to the women's final, we've got the men's semi-finals. Good start from, I think it's the Finn Poikkanen. So Bauer, Marius Bauer from Germany. Oh, and John Steele Hagenbuch making a move. So Hagenbuch deciding to set the pace. Went hard, went early. Of course, if you go fast, then you increase your chances significantly as going through as the lucky loser. And I think that's what Hagenbuch is planning. So a fast heat is a good heat, and John Steele Hagenbuch from the USA is pushing things really hard at the beginning. Nice little move there from Marius Bauer there of Germany. Just nip in on the inside of the corner. So now the climb. Watch for the Frenchman, Tom Mancini, as they go through the 1.1 kilometer mark. really is nothing in it. They're flying up this hill, though. Bauer, Mancini, Hagenbuch, Pueyo, Poikkanen. But Mancini is the one. Mancini's got the speed at the top of the hill. It's Mancini leading down the descent. A little bit of daylight between Mancini and the second place skier. It's Bauer. Bauer's in second. Oh, a little bit of a wobble there from Pueyo of Spain. Managed to get forward and get out of the back seat. It's a quick semi-final. Mancini definitely through. And Bauer, did Pueyo just nick that at the end? Ooh. It doesn't get much closer than that. I'm going to leave that one for the judges. Well, Bauer has gone through exactly the same time. And Pueyo will have to wait 2:29.91 plus 35 hundredths. So this is the second of the semi-finals. Adam Witkowski of USA, Will Koch in one and two. So two Americans involved in the middle of the pack. Settle into their rhythm and Will Koch deciding to go out in front, and Witkowski just coming up from behind. Adam Witkowski. So wearing bib three is the American Will Koch. Cheers have gone, Will, as the coaches will be shouting some encouragement. Will Koch doesn't mind leading from the front. You see some of these turns starting to get a little bit chopped up. So here we go, everyone is still in touch. As we come around the dead turn, who will have the speed for the climb? For me, it doesn't seem as fast as the first of the semi-finals. And Will Koch pushing things hard as we come to the intermediate time at 1.1 kilometers. 1:41.76, Luft in second, Karsrud in third. Iso Triari of Finland in fourth. And now the afterburners have turned on. And Will Koch is going to lead down the descent, under the little bridge there, past the lodge. Oh, was that a move by Luft? So Will Koch, oh, dropped into third as he went round the final bend. Koch was going to have to go some now if he wants to go through. I don't think this is as quick as the first of the semi-finals. It's a race for second place. It's still flat out for second. I think Koch has got it. Karlsruhe, Koch and Luft from Kazakhstan missing out. So 2:34.40 was the time for semi-final number two. Considerably slower, the second of the semi-finals. So it was only going to be two that went through. So time for the women's final. Beautiful scenes here. Erin Bianco will lead things out. Hila Niemela, Anna Maria Dietz, Marielle Pules, Tia Oikonen, and Siri Kaijan Sinko of Finland. So three Finns, an American and a German. They're off and they're running. We've got three Finns in this competition. Will they use team tactics? And two of the Finns going out hard, going out fast. Olkonen and Niemela. Aaron Bianco wearing bib number one there, just settling into second place. Anna-Maria Dietz of Germany. You can see the German in the black and gold. The Finns are easy to recognize in the blue and white. Aaron Bianco of the United States with a USA on her leg and all of the home fans cheering. And Bianco, it is that gets out towards the front. Don't want to expend too much energy on that little climb because the big climb is coming up. Breathing hard, trying to get the oxygen into the system now. Anticipation of what's going to come now. Look at that move from Anna-Maria Dietz on the inside. Really cutting the corner off, but didn't give herself any room to set up. And it was Dietz that basically came through and took out one of the Finns. I'm not sure, I think that might have been Niemela that went down. Yes, it was. And Anna-Maria Dietz, well, she just went in like a motor racing driver, not setting up for the corner and just cutting everyone off on the inside. Olkonen leading Bianco of the USA, Pules of Estonia in third place. Anna-Maria Dietz of Germany hanging in there, staying in touch. But it's Olkonen that leads on the descent, bib seven. Bianco of the United States. Pules is in third.
And on their way to the final.
Oh, Bianco lying in third place now. We've got Finland. Oh, really tight around the final bend. They're going flatter. Oh, a big problem there for Bianco. Bianco getting caught in the back seat and is out of contention for the medals. It's Anna-Maria Dietz that comes through, but look at this. It's going to be Pules that will take the win. Pules of Estonia wins with Olkonen of Finland in silver. Anna-Maria Dietz of Germany takes the bronze. And Erin Bianco just lost control as she came around that final corner and could not get a balance for the final sprint. This was the final move, and look at the American lose balance there and get caught in the back seat, and that allowed the German to come through, threw away a potential bronze medal there, the American. But the power between the first two, and that was incredible by Pules of Estonia. Marielle Pules will take the gold. Tia Oikonen will take the silver, and Anna-Maria Dietz of Germany the bronze. So time for the men's final. Mancini, Christopher Karlsrud, Will Koch, Marius Bauer, Jaime Pueyo of Spain, and Veneri Poikkanen of Finland will be our finalists. So who's it gonna be? The men's final is underway. Six are on the course, only three can win a medal. Marius Bauer getting out first. That was definitely in his game plan, and a little bit of a false start. And that was why he wants to lead this one out. Tom Mancini from France settling into second place. looking for Will Coke. He's down in fifth. Early days in this sprint. Don't want to use too much energy up early. Really, you're going to go into the red. Oh, they've slowed it right down. Look at this. This is like proper cat and mouse stuff. Well, it's the last race of the day, and they want to have some energy for this final sprint up the hill. It's all going to come down to who's got the juice left, who's got the energy left. Will Coke there, some serious work to do. Will Coke, now they go for it, now they go hard. Will Coke moving up. He's got a lot to catch up. Look at Preo of Spain move up. But it's Tom Mancini. Tom Mancini's going to take the lead as they go over the top. Mancini is leading with Preo of Spain. It's France and then Spain on the descent. So Mancini leads. The others in the slipstream, able to catch back up. Who's got the best wax? Oh, wow. It's going to be Poikkanen's got the best wax, that's for sure. The Finn coming, charging through. The Finn's going to do this. The Finn is going to take the gold. It's going to be Finland, followed by Preo of Spain. And then photo, but I think it's Mancini that's going to get the bronze from Bauer. So Poikkanen moving ahead on that final descent, absolutely flying down that descent. Great wax on the skis and able to take the lead going into the final turn and then put on the afterburners on the start finish straight. Yeah, he kisses his skis. Well, might he do so, because they had some wonder wax on them there. Vaini Poikkanen from Finland is the gold medalist. Juanma Preo of Spain in silver. Tom Mancini of France in bronze.
Veneri Poikkanen!
Veneri Poikkanen from Finland takes the gold. Superb speed down the descent and able to move from third place into first.
Mario Merli
Poulos. Our winners. Congratulations to our medalists in the women's sprint competition.